Good afternoon, everyone. Let us continue the second session of today's class. In the previous session, we have already discussed radiation intensity, how it is defined and how it is presented in the form of an equation, and what is the final equation which we use for radiation intensity. It is the power radiated per unit solid angle. And the beam efficiency, it has two parameters actually, beam efficiency and stray factor. If you take the ratio of major lobe beam area to the overall beam area, that is beam efficiency. And if you take the ratio of a minor lobe beam area to the overall total beam area, you get the stray factor. It is just like your efficiency and redundancy of ITC. Then coming to the directivity, capital D, you have seen how it is defined, and equation 1 shows the directivity equation D equals to the power density or the pointing vector. Here we have taken it as P. In the earlier case, while dealing with the power density and the patterns, we have used the notation S. So a maximum value of that power density or the pointing vector to the average value, and we have seen how we can equation can be derived, this B equals to how we can modify this equation. We started with the denominator. The denominator says we should have average value. So average value we have taken over 1 by 4 pi surface integral and the power sin theta d theta d phi, spherical coordinate system, and we have substituted it as d omega. Then this thing we have substituted here in the denominator. D equals to numerator as it is, substitution of the denominator. Then little rearrangements, 4 pi will go to the numerator, and this P max, it is denominator of the denominator, which is equal to numerator. It is just like if you have A by 1 by, if you have, say, A by B, how you can write this? A divided by, numerator, you take it 1, B divided by A. Whatever is there in the numerator, take it to the denominator of the denominator. That's what has been done here, denominator of the denominator. It will come here. Little rearrangements. What this signifies, this ratio, it is the normalized power pattern, Pn of theta phi. N indicates normalized. And this normalized power pattern, this is the equation for beam area. So this is the relationship between directivity and beam width. What conclusion we can make for directivity? Let us see. Some points I have listed here. Very first thing, smaller the beam area, larger the directivity. Means they are inversely related to one another. Okay, if B increases, omega A decreases, or vice versa. Then for an antenna which radiates only over half a sphere, if the area of coverage for a beam area, it is say half of the sphere, then the area covered will be half of the total angle. Total solid angle for sphere is 4 pi. We know this already. It is 4 pi. And if it radiates half of the sphere, only half of the sphere is covered, means it is 2 pi, okay, 360 degrees. Then substitute that here, 2 pi, you will get B value as 2. One example is given here. Next, in the previous section, in the previous antenna parameter, I had told you what is an isotropic antenna, which radiates in all directions and its efficiency is 100%. And as it is radiating in all directions, the angle, the beam width will be totally covered, something like this. If this is the antenna surrounding it all, it will radiate in all directions. So the angle will be 4 pi. So if you substitute this here, 4 pi divided by 4 pi, you will get directivity as 1. And remember, isotropic antenna is a hypothetical antenna which is not existing in practice. Hence, if you consider all practical antennas which are all working now presently at present, all those antennas will have the directivity greater than 1, because ideal value is 1. Considering isotropic antenna, the overall beam width, so that is equal to in all directions beam, so 4 pi. So that's why if you take actual practical antennas, the D value will be always greater than 1. And at the least value, you can get D equals to 1. Not less than that, you will get all more value only. This is one thing. As a note, I have specified something. You just look it out. Directivity can also be defined as how we have defined it earlier. It is the ratio of maximum power density to the average value of the power density. That ratio we have taken. It can also be expressed in terms of U. What is capital U? It is radiation intensity. The previous parameter which we have discussed in the previous session, radiation intensity, capital U. So we can define directivity in terms of U also. How? It is defined as the ratio of maximum radiation intensity to the average radiation intensity. You can see here, directivity is like this. UM indicates maximum, U naught indicates say average. Okay. In earlier, how it was? Maximum by average power density. But here, if you see, it is maximum radiation intensity by average radiation intensity. So we can define it in both ways. U naught is the power that can be received if the system radiates uniformly in all directions, that is hypothetical antenna, isotropic antenna. We always compare it, right? Then coming to the next antenna parameter after directivity, it is called gain. The gain denoted as G, capital G of an antenna, it is the actual quantity which is less than the directivity. Sometimes, you know, gain and directivity are interchangeable terms. Sometimes. But however, what will happen for a hypothetical antenna, we have calculated directivity. And obviously, for hypothetical antenna, gain will be 100%. Okay. But in practice, whenever we try to realize these parameters for practical antennas, it is that quantity which is always less than the directivity. Why? Because in order to calculate the gain, you have to consider certain losses. Just like if you are, the power is radiating, certain losses get associated while traveling. Okay, any signal if travels through a medium, there exist many losses like insertion loss, then heat loss. There are many losses associated whenever a wave travels. So considering all these losses, obviously your gain will always be less than the directivity. Now, the ratio of gain to the directivity is called antenna efficiency factor, that is ratio of gain by directivity. We call this antenna efficiency factor, say K. Okay? And if you just want gain out of this, gain is equal to G into D. This is the equation where K is the efficiency factor. In practice, G is always less than D, because whenever D gets multiplied, if you see what is the range of K, it is in fractions. It is not in, after one number. If it was, suppose it is say K is equal to 2 or something, when it gets multiplied by some bigger factor, G will be more. Assume if directivity for any practical antenna is equal to 2, if K is equal to 2, 2 into 2, 4. Here directivity is 2, gain is 4, which is not possible. So K value is it's in points. So instead of taking 2, if I take 1 by 2, which is in between 0 to 1, so half into D, you'll get add the max gain equal to 1, right? So gain will always be less than the directivity. Gain can be measured how? By comparing the maximum power density you have used either S or P, okay? Maximum power density of an antenna under test, that is which practical antenna you are considering, for which you want to measure the gain, that antenna's power density, that to maximum power density, with reference to an antenna of known gain, that is some reference antenna we take, okay? With respect to this one particular antenna, there are many different types of antennas you are going to study, like short dipole, Yagi-Uda antenna. There are many different types, helical antenna, spiral, then horn antenna. So you can take any one antenna with known parameters as a reference. You can calculate the gain. Why we are considering a known value of any practical antenna is, with respect to that, it is just like while calculating your percentage, that denominator value is known to you, right? You know it is a standard value. If you are having 6 subjects, say 600 is your total marks. So denominator, it should have certain standard number. So that we can do it by making use of one certain antenna whose values are known to you. That will be your reference antenna. So reference antenna's power density and the gain, both values should be known to you. Then the power of your whichever antenna you are designing, that this will give you the gain of that antenna. This is the formula for calculating the gain. Now, as a note, I have written here something. Please do follow it. We have already derived this equation just now. D equals to 4 pi divided by omega A. And omega A is the beam width, which is equal to theta HP and phi HP. This we have already seen while dealing with the beam width, that is beam solid angle. And 4 pi, you can just try to convert it into square degrees. You will get 41253. How? Let me just go back a little. I'll show you here. Yeah. If you see 4 pi, convert it to this. That is 180 into pi whole square. Just multiply. This number is nothing but this 180 into pi divided by pi whole square into 4 pi. 4 pi, you will get somewhat like this. This number I have used. So numerator is 4 pi converted into square degrees, and this omega A we have already seen, it is theta HP into phi HP. So directivity can be found, this directivity can be found if these two values are known to us. What are these two values? They are HP, half power beam widths. If for any antenna we know this theta HP and phi HP, we can calculate directivity. This is one thing. Then here I have written 41253, how I got it. It is 4 pi into that much. This is the note which I have written here. Then what I have done, just approximating to a whole number, which is, as an example, if I take HP BW is equal to 20, assume that 20. If this is 20, the other plane value will also be 20. 20 into 20, 400. I will get 400 denominator. Just to, make it a whole, what I will make, this numerator, I will approximate to 40,000. Okay, there is no hard and fast rule that it should be 40,000 only. Just to make it a whole number. So that just one example I am taking it here. If I take 40,000, two zeros gets cancelled, 4 gets cancelled, you will get 100 if I approximate the numerator to 40,000. But if you take it as a whole, you can just calculate this from your calculator, 41253 divided by 41, I think you will get 103, not much difference, 100 and 103. Okay, what does this mean? directivity is equal to 100 or 103. What it means? It means antenna which you have designed, it radiates, the value is 100. 100 times the power in the direction of main beam as isotropic antenna, because isotropic antenna efficiency and every radiation it is 100%. So with reference to isotropic antenna, your antenna designed, it will radiate 100 times the power in the direction of main beam. Why it is specifying that main beam only? Because for calculation of efficiency and directivity, this major lobe is important. That's why it is the main beam we are specifying. 100 times more as compared to your isotropic antenna. I hope you are clear with this concept of directivity and gain. In the next, I have one sample problem. We'll just look at this. The normalized field pattern of an antenna, it is given by E is equal to sine theta and sine phi. Theta is the zenith angle and phi is the azimuth angle. I think these two are known terms to you, that is latitude and longitude, we say. Okay. Sorry, I'm unable to draw it. Something like this. I hope it looks like spherical coordinate system. This direction we call it theta, zenith angle, and this direction is your phi, that is azimuth angle. Okay. Both are given to you and they have given you the range also for theta and phi. General range is theta is 0 to pi, phi is 0 to 2 pi. That's what we have just now seen in surface integral two lines. We have substituted theta is 0 to pi, phi is 0 to 2 pi. But here specifically they have given you the range. So let's take that only. And 0 elsewhere. So E is this much and angles are given to you. Find the exact directivity and approximate directivity and the decibel difference. Let's see how to calculate the decibel difference afterwards. First, start with the exact directivity. Remember, we have just now derived one equation which is the relationship between this D and omega A. Or before this, we have one equation. I'll just show you the equation. This one. This equation, just remember this, this is the equation for beam a solid angle. Omega is equal to surface integral power into d omega. So you're making use of that equation. Here you can see we have the formula d equals to 4 pi divided by omega a. Just now I have shown you what is omega a, which is equal to surface integral, and ranges they have already given you 0 to pi, 0 to pi, theta and phi. Here inside it is actually, according to the formula, it is surface integral of power, normalized power, theta, phi, comma, d omega. This is the formula for this. However, what is given to you in the equation, you can check. E is given to you. So you are knowing what is the relationship between power and electric field intensity. The relation is power is equal to, even in the earlier power density term, you have seen this, E square by 120 pi, right? Or you might have taken P equals to VI or V equals to E square, E by L. Yeah, V square into V square divided by R and E square by L square. So, relationship between power and E is square term. That's what I have substituted here. You can check it. Whatever E is given to you, that square, because the relationship between power and electric field is this, into d omega as it is. Then coming to the next numerator as it is, I will split this sin theta and sin phi whole square. I have written it like this, and the d omega is sin theta d phi. That substituted. Then take the theta powers all at once. You will get sin cube theta and sin square theta d theta d phi as it is. Then coming to the next, two integrations are there. One is theta, one is phi. Right? I will split it. These two terms I will club and I will keep it here. And remaining one more term would be, sin cube theta and d theta. I will take it here with one integral, which has theta. Then another integral of phi, I will club these two. I will write it. Now, numerator is 4 pi. Here, you can see it. One integral value I have written 4 by 3. One more integral value I have written, pi by 2. And we will get this 6 as the answer. Okay? Now, one homework for all of you. I hope you have known what can be the homework. Anybody? What will be the work for today's class? Yes, how we get this equal to 4 by 3, how we get one more integral as pi by 2. This is the work given to you. I hope you will do this. It's an integration part you might have dealt with in POC and M1, M2 somewhere. You might have dealt with definite integrals. Okay, definite integrals wherein if some sign of some general raised to n theta, if n is even and n is odd, what can be the formula? Shortcut, if you know, you do it. You just put the formula. Or at least by doing the integration calculation, you should get this. I have these answers already with me. Let me see how many of you can try at least. Try and get these answers. If you are unable to get it after one day or two days, just recall me, just remind me. I will give you the answers for these two. Okay? At least let's try. Try to do it by our own. This is about the first question. Exact directivity. Using this formula, we have calculated. Using the formula, we have calculated the exact directivity d equals to 4 pi by omega a. That we got it 6. Now, coming to the approximate directivity, how we can calculate? Just now in the earlier section, I have shown you what is d equal to. D is equal to 41,253 square degrees. Okay, square degrees, when you convert it to 4 pi into that, 180 by pi square, you get this. Divided by, I have written here 90 and 90 directly. How I get that? Because denominator, I think the formula is theta HP and phi HP. Okay. So, according to the given conditions, if you see the range for theta and phi, it is 0 to pi, that is 180 degrees overall. So, your this major beam, main lobe, it is somewhat like this, covering the area of total 0 to 180, that is first quadrant and second quadrant. Looking at these two ranges, we have seen that this is the probably the pattern. If you check here, what is half power beam width? It will be half of it. Okay, so for our given question, your theta HP and phi HP will be 90 degrees. Okay, So 90 degrees. Just if you are having calculator, you can just calculate and confirm me the answer. Multiply this and 90 into 90. 8100. 41253 divided by 8100. Can anybody tell me? Let me calculate. Anybody?
5.09.
So if 092. 092. Okay. So whatever you will get, you write it. They have approximated in your textbook as 5.1. So 09, I think they have taken it as 10. 5.1. But however, you can keep the same. No problem. Whatever you get, you write it. Now tell me, what will be the unit for this? Anyone? Year also and year also. I have not written the unit. Why is it so? Quickly tell me. Somebody has messaged degree. Unit is degree. You feel so? Think one more time. Check the numerator and denominator. What are the units for numerator and denominator? Numerator, you are having square degrees, and this is your degree into degree. You will get one more square degrees. Numerator is also square degree, denominator is also square degree. So it is a dimensionless quantity, both gets cancelled. So it is unitless. You don't have any unit. Directivity is just a number. Okay? That's why I have not written anything after this 6 or 5.1. So this is about calculation by using the approximate method. The first one was exact method. Now, the third question, if you see, decibel difference. How much difference in decibels these two directivities are having? For that, decibel difference, it doesn't mean that, 5.1 or 6 minus 5.1, something. Difference is not like that. In decibels, the difference we calculate as a ratio. Okay? That's why the formula will be 10 log. Whatever exact directivity you got divided by the approximate directivity, then we will get the decibel difference. Taking the ratio, it is not the subtraction. Okay? Because when you go for why we get this ratio, because I think you know this already while dealing with logarithms. It is log a by b, which is equal to log a. I hope it is log. Log b.
Minus log b.
So here it's a difference. So if I club this formula, you will get log of a by b. Similarly, here it is log a, that is whatever exact value you get. In decibels, how we take it is 10 log of 6. Okay. Then for approximate directivity, it is 10 log of 5.1. So you will get some answer here A, some one more answer B. So if you take A minus B, the formula will be 10 log of A by B. Sorry, not this, here. 6 by 5.1. So the formula is this. Directly it's written here, but the base I have given you here. Logarithmic, when you take the difference, it is actually the ratio. So the decimal difference you can calculate from the calculator. What is 10 log of 6 by 5.1? I hope you will get the answer. Are you trying? 10 log of 6 by 5.09. I will get, see here, I have got it here, 0.714 I got. So only 0.7 is written, fine. It is in decibels. So I, yes, I hope you have understood this problem. Both exact directivity and approximate directivity, how to calculate. Now coming to the next, it's a small parameter, directivity and resolution. Can anybody tell me what do you mean by a resolution? Rules, you are coming to New Year resolution. No, it is not like that. It is not rule. Anybody?
Quality for clear things.
Yes, yes, it is about clear and quality. Because you might have heard this resolution word in case of your TVs, right? A resolution is this watch, even in case of camera, resolution and all. So it's about quality, yes, and how much clear the thing is, clear the image or the video is. That is called resolution. So how directivity and resolution, they are related. The resolution of an antenna, it is defined as half of the beam width between first nulls. Resolution is given by this BWFN divided by 2. Half the BWFN, it is approximately equal to this. We have this ratio already. Okay? Remember, whenever we have already seen HP BW, it is theta HP into phi HP. It is equal to BWFN divided by 2. Remember this always. This divided by 2 will give you HPBW, and according to the definition, BWFN divided by 2 is the resolution. Okay, so how we can write this? Just now we have seen theta HP into pi HP is the solid angle. Substitute both HPBW in terms of BWFN, this also in terms of BWFN. This is for theta and this is for phi. If you take that, now if capital N is the number of transmitters which are radiating, which are distributed uniformly in the sky, assume that there are, you know, multiple radios, a number of transmitters are there, they are distributed over the sky, which an antenna can resolve, okay, which an antenna can identify clearly, then it is approximately equal to your